You know, James, you remind me of myself a bit. Reminds me of how I earned a reputation worth keeping.
Getting your ass kicked around all day?
When I left Cranny, I was maybe 11. I was a little shite too. And I knew Limerick was a rough town.
Ah, rough town, Limerick, rough town.
In Cranny, your worst beating would have come from your ma.
Cranny, not a rough town. Should never admit that, Bill.
What are you, Jerry Lewis? Go fetch me a pint, will you? Thirsty. So, my father says to me before he left, he says, if you're going to get into a row, which is unavoidable in Limerick, don't go fighting a guy who f***ed with you. And I said, what do you mean by that? And he says, for effect, I suppose. So I'd remember it, you know. Yeah. Whispers in my ear. Then he kisses me on the cheek. And off I go.
That sounds very interesting. And the other thing I started to tell you about your wife is every time I asked where you were, you were in Europe doing a movie, and then she said, well, now he's in Des Moines doing a movie. It's like one, I mean, you just don't stop.
I shoot in all the great places.
Yes, evidently. Well, did you just shoot this Irish film, or that was another movie you were shooting in Europe?
No, the one I was shooting in Des Moines is called Janey Jones, and that one I only wrapped about 5 days ago, so it certainly wouldn't be able to be ready to come out in November.
That's okay.
But
it'll be coming out eventually because your co-star is.
Yeah, it's the young and talented Abigail Breslin is my co-star. It's about a kind of indie rock singer who is in a band that had a fair amount of success, but is now a bit on the wane, and he's in the middle of a tour, a fairly low-rent tour across America, and he's a pretty serious alcoholic, and one night before one of his concerts, a woman comes backstage, this woman played by Elizabeth Shue, who tells him that they have a 12-year-old daughter together. And she then abandons this little girl at the concert and disappears. And he's left having to take this girl, who may or may not be his daughter, onto the rest of the tour with him. And it's about the relationship that develops between the father and the girl does indeed turn out to be his daughter.
She does all these things, Abigail Breslin, and they're very high profile, and they're all people go to them, and
it's a great role for her, because it's a sort of, I think it's a bit of a transitional role, from being a child to being an adult. She's about 13 now, and she plays a 12, 13-year-old in the story as well, and it's just that age where you're half child, half adult.
Yes.
She's so perfectly poised in that moment in her life that it was a perfect role for her, and she's wonderful. And I this was the perfect thing for me to do after the Chanel movie, because I the Chanel film is very emotionally restrained, a bit like Remains of the Day or something, where the characters don't express their emotions in a big way.
Is that a very French thing, do you think?
No, but my character was English in the film, although I speak French. And English, he was not only English, but English of a certain class and a certain period. And it wasn't the custom at that time to yell and scream and weep and wail. And so big, important emotional decisions are made in a very understated way, whereas the movie that I just finished with Abby is, I play basically a punk rock singer who's drunk half the film and sort of thrashing around.
I can't wait.
I was obviously a bit long in the tooth to be playing this part, because I kept getting whiplash at the ends of these concert scenes where I was injuring myself. Well, and then there's one other film, which is a film called Howl, which is about
Is that the one you just
Alan Ginsburg.
Shot?
I shot that just before this, yeah. But it was really a short stint for me. A bunch of us, me and Jeff Daniels and Mary Louise Parker and Treat Williams and couple of other people did sort of a couple of days on it as witnesses. It's all about the obscenity trial over the Alan Ginsburg poem, Howl.
Wow.
Which was very controversial in his time because of its kind of pornographic imagery. And so we came in to play witnesses for the prosecution or for the defense. But James Franco plays Ginsburg, and Bob Balaban is the judge.
Oh, love him, yeah.
John Hamm, I think, is one of the prosecutors, and David Strathairn. So it was a big ensemble of people, but it was a lot of fun. And I think it's going to be an interesting movie. It's pretty experimental. It's in three parts that keep alternating. There's recreations of his early life where James is playing him, and then there are these sort of psychedelic animations which play over bits of the poem that are read by Ginsburg's actual voice, and then scenes from the trial with all that cast that I've described, and all three of them sort of move back and forth, interwoven through the story.
You always get these really interesting projects, Alessandro, one right after the other, and guess what? This is another interesting project that's just about done. We've got about 1 minute left, and I can't believe that we've flown through a whole Stephen Holt show again. And they all sound so fascinating, and they just, these unusual sort of quirky indie projects come to you. And how can you talk Coco Avant Chanel this year? I mean, that, and directed by a woman, beautifully, the costumes, oh my God. Nominations for everybody.
Yeah, which was a tall order for a movie about a great fashion designer.
Well, they seem to have the support of the House of Chanel, and you have the support of the House of Holt here, the House of Nivola and Mortimer, and the House of Holt, and we're gonna wind up here. And thank you once again.
Thanks.
For being on the show.
It's a real pleasure, and I look forward to 2 weeks from now when we'll do it again.
Oh, okay, whatever you want. It's all about
it's
him.
It's becoming a salon.
Right. Well, it's a saga. It's a saga. I love it. Anytime you got something to talk about, we'll talk. Okay.
All right.
Thanks, Alessandro.
Again.
Have a fabulous.